Hey guys, this is day one.
This is day two.
Day five.
I think it must be day 21 or something like that.
With dolphins and pristine beaches, there are worse places to self-isolate than a desert island. So when the last flight out of the Yemeni archipelago of Socotra departed, travel vlogger Ava Zubek remained.
I came here in early March to run a marathon here, and I did run it, but then kind of, the world started shutting down all around us, and I ended up staying on the island.
More than 2 months in, and she has no idea when she'll get home. Socotra, unlike its war-ravaged mainland, is generally peaceful. It's a UNESCO World Heritage Site, and pre-pandemic, it received just one passenger flight a week. For Zubek, who travels to places most people don't, that was part of the attraction.
We found this beautiful cave, we found a lot of roads. Life on the island is pretty slow. It's pretty simple, actually. The island doesn't have shopping malls or cinemas.
Just after 5:30 a.m. in the morning.
I usually end up waking up around sunrise and fasting with the family that's hosting me here in a tiny little mountain village. I read, I write, I hike around the mountains.
Come back here.
There have been some on social media who've criticized Zubek for coming in the first place, potentially introducing the virus to the island.
In the hospital, right here. Around the beginning of March, we didn't realize just how serious it was. And I remember looking at all sorts of travel advisories. It was only a few days later, really quickly, that the situation kind of escalated and suddenly the travel advice changed 180 degrees. We were actually checked upon arrival to Socotra, and that reassured us that we wouldn't be introducing anything to Socotra. But I am trying to contribute to the people of the island by being here in any way that I can.
What seems like a chance to extend a stay in paradise has taken a turn, and weeks have now become months.
I wonder every single day how much longer I'll be here. In a couple of weeks, in 3 or 4 weeks, the monsoon season begins. So I'm concerned about that. I think if I had to choose, if there was a flight tomorrow, I think I would probably take it.